former world champion, Narantungalag Jadambaa. This man, though, is such a fan favorite around the world because his style is nothing but all-out aggression and sheer power. He is a beast in every sense of the word.
He gets better every time. I don't know what this guy is doing out there in the hills of Mongolia, but he's just getting sharper and sharper.
Plenty of it coming from the heavy artillery, the bombardment, and the ground and pound. Narantungalag Jadambaa has taken on the biggest names in the sport. There is no one this man won't go up against. The overhand right, the left hook. What a combination of power from Jadambaa. What a performance, a power-laden performance from the former world champion. Ah, the big gavage, and good night, Irene!
Mila G, I've just noticed that these two have an identical mixed martial arts record of 8-3.
Judge.
Bit of trivia for you. This fight is brought to you by Naga World, the best business, leisure, and integrated resort in Cambodia. Not much leisure time going on here for the next 15 minutes, if it lasts that long.
You know, as a fan of mixed martial arts, I'm really, really, really excited to see Jadambaa fight.
Oh!
There has been a tremendous amount of hype around him for years. You know, for the last 3 or 4 years, ever since he really started turning the corner there in his mixed martial arts career and on that 7-8 fight win streak.
Right hand from Banario. That's what he's about. He has explosive power.
Well, he's getting right back in the mix here with a very tough opponent. Banario is absolutely just a beast when it comes to striking prowess.
Oh, right hand. I mean, we're seeing it, aren't we? Make your ONE FC debut against a former champion. You know you're going to be up against something, and that something comes in a big right hand from the Filipino.
Yeah, Jadambaa is a lot stronger than he looks. He's dropping down for the first time from lightweight. But I had a chance to talk to a few different people that train with Jadambaa, and they just said that, man, he's really strong for his size.
You say he looks stronger than he looks. He looks strong to me. He's got a hard upper body, isn't he?
Him even looking, being stronger than that. It's funny sometimes, as a fan of the sport, we sit here and we watch the commentary screens and we just get so engrossed in what awesome fights are happening. You realize that we haven't really said anything for a couple of minutes.
Apologies for that. It's engrossing stuff, though.
Oh, it's great. The best job in the world here.
Oh, kick to the stomach there.
Speaking of which, I have not been marking my scorecard. Man, it's great action. It's very evenly matched, too, both on paper. I think that the wrestling could very well be who can dictate where this fight takes place.
It's very fluid stuff, isn't it, from both men?
It is, both back and forth. And stylistically, too, you see a little more of the karate style versus the wushu, which is one of the things I love about ONE FC. You know, stateside, there tends to be this kind of pattern we have where, okay, you've got to wrestle, you've got to do jiu-jitsu, and then taekwondo. Just missed that takedown. Or Muay Thai, I think I just said taekwondo, watching that takedown happen.
No more than 2 meters away from us at cage side here.
Now, this is a spot that Jadambaa probably hasn't been in a tremendous amount.
He's taken a battering from Bonario's left hand. And now the right.
Jadambaa needs to close his guard or start putting his feet on the hips of Bonario to push him away. He doesn't want to keep his guard open. Bonario's going to just push down on that knee and start to work the pass. It's not going to be hard for him to do that. You see right now, Jadambaa's holding Bonario's head down. That's really just kind of a stall tactic so that Bonario can't posture up and
just closing that gap.
Yeah, throw all that.
Well, he had the right foot on the hip, but it slipped away. And now the option to push him away is gone.
Yeah, you want to keep your guard closed. It's one of the first things they teach you in jiu-jitsu so that you can control your hips of your opponent and where they go, extend away or pull them in towards you. That's Gracie Jiu-Jitsu 101.
Well, I was telling you that we're 2 meters away. Our cameraman is less than 30 centimeters away for a while.
Well, Jadambaa does a good job getting back up. He's trying to work on that front guillotine. It's more just like a headlock at this point. I don't know that he has it in deep enough. Still have to be careful, though. Oh, a nice right and left. Honorio Banario has been training Wushu for so long. He was a member of the Philippines Wushu team. Actually went to college on a Wushu scholarship.
Yeah.
And Wushu's a great striking base for mixed martial arts. Combines the unorthodox striking, a little bit of kung fu meets kickboxing and some takedowns.
What wonderful back and forth action we're getting here.
And Jadambaa's got some quads too. Nice left uppercut. You don't see the lead uppercut too much.
Final 10 seconds are approaching.
Jadambaa's just kind of methodical with that leg kick. Just chopping down with it.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful kick. In the final second of that round. Jadambaa wanted to come back into it. Banario said, hold on, we've finished the round here. Go and have a rest. That's what I'm going to do. What a way to finish off that round, though, from Banario. The flat of his foot on the flat of Jadambaa's chin. A compact, strong man, this Mongolian is. And what fluid action we saw from these two. Seamless movement between hands and feet in the attack from both men. Used to seeing that from the Wushu-based fighters.
That was like a laser. Nario's foot was like a heat-seeking missile, man. That's, you have to be so fast and so talented to be able to pull off that flashy, higher-risk stuff. Your foot has to travel such a long distance. Just shows you how quick Banario is.
Second round action.
I can tell you right away that this is one of those fights I would not want to be a judge for.
Oh, what a left hand from Jadambaa, and it caught Banario slightly off balance. And that was a very good left hand right on the chin.
Man, that was just a cracking hand on the chin. You hear that cage side.
Another good clubbing left hand came in, but Banario carries that guard nice and high. Open hands either side of the face. You see it quite a lot.
Oh, nice takedown defense and a nice follow-up. And reversal.
That's crazy stuff.
That's sick. That was great back and forth action. Great double leg penetration by Banario. That was very nice counter and then follow through.
The action has just been relentless since the very first bell.
Great action so far, you know, less than halfway through, and you look at striking superiority, and I think it's almost on par with each other. I think I might start to move Jadambaa up a little bit after kind of those early connections at this point. The ground control has been a little back and forth, but Banario got off some more shots on the ground and was able to advance the position. But he's eaten a couple of solid 4-ounce leather gloves tonight. Jadambaa's got that inside position, which is very difficult to defend. He's trying to squeeze forward and get the leg trip. Nice takedown.
Well, the action is just coming thick and fast. The judges' pencils are almost worn out. So much going on in this fight.
Oh, a nice right here.
Yeah, Bonario's head came cannoning off the canvas after that.
See Jadambaa, how he's leading with his left leg as opposed to standing with his hips square so that he doesn't get that up kick. Or if Banario up kicks, it'll slide off his chest. And Benario's pass guard here. see what he can do in the terms of submission. Banario right back to his feet. Great work by both guys. Well, if you haven't been entertained this far for the first 7.5 minutes, hit pause, check your pulse, because this is about as entertaining of a fight as you're going to see in mixed martial arts.
And it's very typical of ONE FC in terms of the styles that are adopted here. You made the point earlier on, Jason, quite a little bit different from what you might see in North America, for example. What I find to be most impressive as the punches continue to fly in is just this seamless movement of attack from
Nice straight right.
And there's a cut. Jadambaa is cut, I think, above the hairline on the left-hand side of his face. Blood trickling down his left jawbone.
You see Jadambaa setting up that left hook every time he sees that Banario is trying to throw a kick. Really been back and forth. Every time Banario throws one, it connects. Jadambaa eats it and comes back with one of his own. This could very well be whoever gets the last punch in a combination, puts the other guys back to the canvas.
Both have shown some fearsome punching.
That was lightningly quick out of the way.
Ghost-like, will-o'-the-wisp movement to the right.
Yeah, you see there, every time Banario's throwing that kick, Jadambaa's loading up that left hook.
Well, there's no stopping these two, is there? Right hand, just the heaviness of it just moved away as Jadambaa moved his face with the punch.
Man, this has just been a tremendously well-matched fight.
Well, it's Matt Hume who does the matchmaking here, so credit to him. He's a fabulous job with this one.
Ooh, nice combination. That's how you can tell when guys have higher level striking. They're mixing up their angles, they're mixing up combinations. Just like that, you see a knee followed up with punches. Almost a takedown.
And what tremendous fitness from these two to maintain this pace as we enter the final 10 seconds of the second round.
I can tell you that I've never been more frustrated looking at my my sheet here marking off damage inflicted and striking superiority.
Not so easy to keep up yourself, Jason, I'm sure.
Yeah, every time I look down to mark one, I look up and the other guy's got a check mark back. It's crazy. What amazing MMA action. You got a friend and you're trying to explain to him what MMA is and why it's awesome. Just show him this fight. It's great back and forth action. Some nice overhand rights and left hooks. Jadambaa here on the inside leg sweep was able to get a little bit of position on the ground. Banario with some good dirty boxing. A nice combination that landed solid in the midsection.
Mongolia against the Philippines. Asian mixed martial arts at its best. More minutes to come.
Fight!
I won't venture a guess at who's in the lead just yet, because I don't frankly know.
I think at this point it's still wide open as far as whoever's going to let this last 5 minutes loose.
It's there to be taken, isn't it?
Got Rich Franklin sitting next to us here, cage side. Rich, how do you see this so far? Rich said, yeah, I heard what you said about the score sheet and I would be just as frustrated. So, you look here, as far as aggression, it's hard really to give credit to anyone because they're both just pushing forward. I have Jadambaa up a little bit. I think he's right on the precipice of getting one more notch in the aggression mark. Jadambaa had really the only clean takedown. There was a little back and forth. There's another takedown attempt and a beautiful double leg by Banario. And belly to back suplex. But you see the the instant mindset by Jadambaa to constantly post and goes right away to fighting the hands.
I won't tell you who we went for, but Jason and I were split before this fight as to who would win it. That's another indication of what a good matchup this is. And it really has proved to be so.
Oh, spinning back kick by Jadambaa. And you know, if you thought that his leg being broken in his last fight may have slowed him down for this fight, not the case.
Oh, to come back from an injury like that with a contest like this and an opponent like this. These men deserve a lot of credit. Banario, remember, coming back from losing his world championship belt. Fire in their bellies, both of these men.
And 2 minutes and 30 seconds left, and I really think this could be either guy's, you know, ability to take this fight is just right in front of them. It's so close up to this point.
Well, you wouldn't be at all surprised if the judges are split on this one.
Yeah, I mean, as far as the damage inflicted, Banario did open up a little cut on Jadambaa's head, and that very well may be the definitive.
Oh, right hand from Jadambaa caught Banario flush on the nose, and he took it well.
And another right, that just went right through the gloves of Banario. Obviously, the most important thing we look for in ONE FC is who came close to the knockout or submission. But if there's no knockout or submission, which there very well may be in the last 2 minutes here,
Jadambaa wasn't far off there. Another swinging right. Banario on a left as well. And Banario is taking the worst of it now, having missed with the right hand.
And Banario, man, his wrestling has just looked so much improved,
that's
too.
That's something we haven't seen so much from him.
Gosh, great
in
wrestling.
The past.
Yeah, just Banario's wrestling has been just looking absolutely incredible. You wouldn't think he just started wrestling, you know, a year or two ago. And Jadambaa's wrestling counters have been great, too. A spinning back fist.
Countered with a left hand from Banario. A minute and a half left in this one. Great right hand from Jadambaa, and he slips. The momentum was so strong that he fell over afterwards. But he caught Banario, no question.
What a crazy fight.
Sadly, there's only just over a minute left of this contest. Wouldn't it be great if this was going five?
Five, ten, whatever it takes. Jadambaa's just swinging for the fences. It looks like Banario's getting a little bit tired, but Jadambaa's showing spectacular takedown defense. That's not hard. You know, guys like BJ Penn work for years, and they're just absolute freaks when it comes to defending the single leg.
He's done very well to stay on his foot there, because one of them, of course, was in Bonario's clutches.
This is one of those situations. Jadambaa may just jump guard if he feels like he's got a solid chance of catching this guillotine, but doesn't look like it's going to be the case.
Final half minute. And the crowd here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium, many of them on their feet, a lot of them applauding these two.
Man, what a great fight this has been.
Oh, that six takedown. I wonder if that'll swing it.
It's not going to hurt. Holy cow.
We always like to try and give you an indication of who we thought won a fight. This one is particularly difficult. If I had to bet my house on it, Jason, I'd go with Jadambaa. What do you think?
Well, you know, I think that this is tough because the way that I have this scored so far as aggression, I have them fairly equal because Jadambaa was moving forward more with the strikes, but Banario was doing a great job with setting up and trying to push the pace for the takedowns. If you're looking at those takedowns, Jadambaa had two solid takedowns and defended Banario's two other takedowns. Banario had one great takedown. Bam. That's kind of like a half takedown, even though there wasn't a lot of position established afterwards.
So do you think, Rich?
The two were pretty even, but Jadambaa pulled it out there in the last round. He did enough damage to take the win for sure, to separate.
All right, then there you go. In the center of the ring, the two fighters, as you'd expect, are showing each other the greatest of respect. And we see that so often that it barely needs my comment.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges seat for your winner via unanimous decision. From the blue corner, Narantungalag Jadambaa!
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.